Hi, everyone. My name is Malcolm, and today Sam and I will be talking about Firebase Authentication.
Hi, folks. I'm Sam. Malcolm and I work together on Firebase, and in our time, we've seen quite a few of the patterns and anti-patterns that people come across when building their apps with Firebase.
We're going to cover a lot of ground today and get into the nitty-gritty of how auth works. A quick shout-out for the super advanced developers out there who are already thoroughly familiar with our auth products. At the end of this video, we'll be delving into custom auth, which is super flexible, super powerful, and unlocks many interesting integrations. With that note out of the way, let's dive in.
In my free time, I develop and maintain my own social cat picture sharing app. Now, I've only worked on Firebase Auth team for a few months or so I'm still getting up to speed. Malcolm has helpfully offered to walk me through some of the technical challenges and decisions I'm dealing with.
Happy to help.
When I was starting out, I went with the most straightforward authentication, email and password. It's pretty great. Very simple to set up, but I've started noticing some limitations with it.
What's wrong?
Well, for one thing, I was recently chatting with a friend who's big into app security. She was saying that many people use the same passwords everywhere. She was also talking about all the different password strength checks you can implement, and that got me wondering.
Yeah. Firebase will give you some basic level of password strength requirements, but if you want to have your own configuration, you'll need to do that yourself. And as far as password reuse, that is a really big concern. Unfortunately, that's also something you'll need to build on your own. You could do both of these things as client-side validation, but ultimately, if you want to actually have real enforcement, this also means running validation on your own service.
Ah, okay. That's good to know. The other problem I've been having is that people have been signing up with fake emails. I know they're fake because they use bogus domains. Someone even signed up with my work email address. I know it wasn't me because I'm a good employee who definitely does not use social media on his working hours. I set up email verification to address this, but my code is getting pretty complicated.
You know, Sam, there's a way to address all of these concerns without having to set up your own server-side code. Email link-based authentication solves many of these problems. Your users would put in their email addresses, then they would receive an email with a link to sign into your app. Right away, that user has a verified email, so you don't need to worry about bogus emails or account squatting. They don't have a password, so password reuse and complexity requirements are no longer a concern, and the code is even slightly less complicated than doing a separate verification flow.
Oh, this is great. I see. So with just these few lines of code, I get all of those benefits. Now, if I wanted to allow users to create a password after all, do I have to give up this email link sign-in?
Nope. You can always just call update password on a signed-in user with the new password. Then you can call sign-in with email and password the next time they want to sign in. Just keep in mind that any validation you want to do on that password needs to happen in your app.
Cool. I'm feeling much better about this. By the way, I've noticed that the emails that my users receive from Firebase are a little on the bare side. Is there any way I can spice them up a bit?
While you can update some parts of the text content in the Firebase console, there's not a whole lot you can do to change the way it looks. Email is a complex system on its own, so Firebase only allows for a narrower range of customization. You can, however, generate your own out-of-band code and send the emails yourself. We have tutorials in our documentation that can walk you through that process.
Ah, okay, I got it. My UX designer, who is my cat, incidentally, wanted to overhaul the emails for the site something like this. Sounds like I'll need to stand up my own service to send them.
Yep, that's definitely something you'll need to use the admin SDK and some other mail service for.
Wow, though, this is starting to get a bit complex. At this point, I'm standing up my own cloud service in order to have better looking emails and to enforce stronger password guidelines. When I joined Firebase, they told me it was serverless.
Your auth integration is starting to get pretty sophisticated. You're handling UX for passwords and out-of-band email flows. You're dealing with password strength requirements. You're ensuring your users own the emails they've given you. While it's great you have dug into the complexity of authentication, you're in the cat photo sharing business, not the security business. Let's see if there's an easier way to delegate some of this complexity to someone else.
Someone else? Like whom?
Well, Google, for starters. Google has entire teams dedicated to making sign-in work seamlessly. Plus, since they own Gmail, Firebase Auth will automatically trust the email account of any user who signs in with Google.
Hold on, though. While I don't wish to denigrate my employer in front of a large audience, how can you suggest that their UX is better than what my cat put together last night? I mean, look how great it is.
All the same, I'm sure your app has plenty of complexity in other ways. Why spend so much time reinventing the wheel? Check this out. We've already talked about how email link sign-in is related to email password sign-in. Well, it turns out that all of the email logins are just a special case of a generic credential-based sign-in. You see, Firebase doesn't actually care what the underlying type of credential is, so long as it's valid. Let's take a look. In the case of email password, it's the email password pair. You send Firebase an email and password, and you get back a user. For email link, it's the email and a short-lived out-of-band code embedded in the link that's sent out. You send Firebase an email address, and it sends an email. You then send Firebase the link and the email again, and Firebase gives you a user. For providers like Google, the thing you exchange for a user is an OAuth token given to us by the Google sign-in flow.
This is starting to make sense. So Firebase Auth is really just a wrapper around some of these other types of authentication?
Yep. I mean, there's a lot that goes into all of this, but at the end of the day, we're talking about a way to uniquely and securely identify users. In the abstract sense, that's what the authentication system does. Everything else is just a layer on top of that abstraction.
Okay, I'm sold. Tell me how I'd go about integrating Google Sign-In into my app.
Sure thing. So, to briefly reiterate, signing into Firebase happens in two steps. One, you get or generate some form of user credential. Two, you exchange that credential for a Firebase token. For email password, step one is just asking your user for their email and password. But for identity providers, that step is just a little bit more complicated.
Oh, is this where you would use something like the Google Sign-In SDK?
Yeah. How do you know about that?
Oh, I had to use that a long time ago so I could programmatically upload cat photos to Google Drive.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Well, you can use an SDK to get tokens for identity providers like Google, Facebook, or Apple that have pre-built SDKs for each platform. Then you can use the OAuth provider class in the Firebase SDK to package the credentials that you've gotten and call sign-in with credential.
Is that it? Don't I somehow have to let Google and Firebase know to talk to each other?
Oh, yeah, good catch. Before you can use tokens from an identity provider, you need to go to the Authentication tab in the Firebase console, go to the Sign-In Method tab, and then enable and configure the identity provider. The configuration is a little different for each provider, but it should be clear to you what you need.
Is that it? How do I know how to use the identity provider SDKs? Do I have to learn a different SDK for each identity provider I want to support?
Well, that depends. The flow we've been talking about so far is what we call the two-legged OAuth flow at Firebase, where it has two distinct steps for developers. However, we do have a simpler way to sign in that's the same for all identity providers.
That sounds great. Why wouldn't you tell me about that first?
Well, it has pros and cons depending on the platform you're on. If you're just building a web app, what we're talking about are the sign-in with pop-up and sign-in with redirect flows. You'll note that those don't make any use of any SDKs other than the Firebase Auth one, and are the default implementation. For Android and iOS, we have a feature we call Generic Identity Provider, or IDP, sign-in. It's a way to basically turn all flows into the web redirect flow on any platform, but that may mean that the experience is out of the norm for your users. It'll be up to you to decide if that meets your users' needs.
I can't tell if that's simple or complicated. How does it work?
Well, the coding part is relatively simple. You set up the appropriate secrets in the Firebase console and the IDP console. On iOS, you set up the appropriate custom URL scheme, and then call the platform-specific sign-in method. On Android, that's start activity for sign-in with provider, and on iOS, it's get credential with.
Okay, that doesn't sound so bad. But what's going on under the hood when everything's set up?
Ah, so that's a little complicated. Check out this diagram.
Okay, let me fill in the parts I can figure out. Looks like we start in the app, and the first call goes out to the browser. Then what?
So, in the browser, we first go to a page that Firebase hosts in your project that we call the Auth Handler. That page talks to the Firebase backend to construct the IDP authentication URI and save some information for the round trip.
Okay, and I think I can guess what happens next. You go to the IDP so the user can sign in. Oh, And then I bet the IDP uses the redirect URL that we registered in their console, right?
Bingo. And that's the same handler we used earlier. It marshals the data from the IDP and uses the information it saved earlier to redirect to the app. Once the app receives that data, it calls the Firebase backend with the credential it got from the IDP to exchange for a Firebase user.
Just like the flow at the SDK. Got it. One last question. I've heard it's unsafe to pass around credentials between apps on mobile devices. I assume we're protected from that?
Yeah. Firebase uses a variant of proof key for code exchange called PKCE, a standard scheme for protecting web-based auth flows on mobile. In short, yes, your user's credentials are safe.
You know, in my free time, I also maintain an authentication service that uses uploaded images of cats instead of passwords. The pixel data provide a ton of entropy, plus it's just more whimsical than reusing the same password over and over but slightly altering one letter.
There is so much wrong with that statement. But if you have your own auth service, why are you asking me so many questions about auth?
I don't know. Maybe I was testing you.
Isn't this pre-recorded? I can just look at the answers in my script.
This is getting too meta. My main question is, I really want to be able to authenticate my users in my social media app using my homemade authentication service. So far, everything you've talked about with Firebase has seemed very managed. It doesn't seem like there's room for my cat picture password process.
Ah, but there is. Firebase Auth supports custom authentication. And when I say custom, I mean just about anything can be used for authentication. Remember how we talked about Firebase Auth just being a wrapper around some form of secure token? Well, that's exactly what custom auth can be. Firebase Auth deals in JSON web tokens, known as JWTs, pronounced JOTs. These underpin every Firebase user, whether they're signed up with email, phone, Google, or any other IDP. Custom Auth allows you to put just about anything in that JSON token, and that will be your user. This happens in two steps, just like the other auth flows. One, generate a custom token using your admin SDK. Two, exchange that custom token for a user.
Whoa, that seems super powerful. How is that secure, though? Couldn't anyone just send in some JSON and call it their token?
Good question. JOTs are more complex than just a JSON string. They're actually composed of three parts: a header, a payload, and a signature. The payload contains interesting things like custom claims, last sign-in timestamps, and the user's UID. The first part, the header, just has some general metadata so that the consumers know how to interpret the JOT. The last one, the signature, is the important one for your question. The tokens are signed by your admin SDK's service account credential, meaning that Firebase can distinguish a valid token from a faked one.
Ah, so next you're going to tell me I need my own backend again.
Well, you'll definitely need code running the admin SDK somewhere. If you want to stay serverless, you could put this in a cloud function, or you could stand up your own server like you mentioned. And whatever you do, don't put it in any code running on a user's device. But once you've reached that point, custom auth is easy. One call to this method with any JSON payload you want will generate a signed JOT. You can return that to your app, and your app can then sign in with it.
This is really cool. So how this works for my system is this. My users sign in by uploading their cat picture password. My auth system returns a unique ID and some metadata for that user. All I have to do is add some function to my app's backend that creates a JOT with that unique ID, and I can even put metadata in there?
Yep. Like I said, almost anything can go into that JOT payload. There are special fields that Firebase cares about, like UID. Then there's the custom claims field, where you can set extra metadata.
Awesome. But how does that get used?
Well, for example, in Firebase rules, you can look at the contents of the JOT to guard access to Firestore.
Cool. So now I can guard access to my app's documents based on how many cats are in the password.
Sure. But in reality, this can be used in lots of powerful ways. Specifying users as having admin powers, for example, is an excellent use of custom tokens.
These JOTs seem almost too flexible. How do I know this is a safe way to do things?
Well, for starters, JOTs are an industry standard. Plus, they're signed by a Google service account tied to your project. There's no way to create a valid JOT for your app without going through your own code executing on a runtime you control.
That makes sense. So I still need to be diligent about what I do with the JOT once it's returned to me from the admin SDK. Is the entire JOT itself the unique key for the user?
No. The UID field is the only one that Firebase uses. So in your example, if your user changed their password to have one fewer cat, the next login to Firebase, the UID would be the same, but any other fields you set in the custom claims, like cat count in your example, can change.
This is really cool. I know realistically my cat auth service is pretty silly, and in reality, it's definitely not something you'd ever want to actually build yourself. But I can see how you could use custom auth to integrate with just about any authentication service you want.
It's definitely super useful. While it's not quite bring your own token to Firebase, it's pretty close. You're not able to log in somewhere else and talk directly to Firestore, for example, but by putting one call to create custom token in between, you effectively have brought that other system's token to Firebase. In fact, there's a recent Firebase blog post by our very own Kevin Chung explaining how to integrate Okta into your Firebase app.
Awesome. Well, this has been super helpful. Though I'm still mad about those email templates, I know my designer had her heart set on her mocks.
Happy to help. I know authentication can seem complicated to navigate, especially when there are so many different options to choose from when selecting your sign-in method.
Yeah, the diagram helps a lot. It seems to me that Firebase Auth is conceptually just a container around some form of secure and trusted token. It all just depends how managed I want the process to be.
Yep, you can have any level of involvement you want. And if you want to do everything yourself, custom auth is just about as flexible as can be.
Cool. It's been great chatting with you, Malcolm, and great diving into some of these more nuanced auth use cases. I'm glad I could pick your brain.
Nice chatting with you too, Sam. Let me know if your new cat app ever takes off.
Thanks, Malcolm. And thanks to all of you watching. I hope you've learned a bit about how Firebase Auth works so that building it into your next app is that much more seamless. Bye, folks.
Bye.